Hello everybody, glad to have you watching. This drawing demonstration is to show you how to create a gridded plane in two-point perspective. You'll need a few supplies: paper, red pencil, graphite pencil, eraser, straight edge like a ruler or a T-square, and drafting triangles. Now, as with every perspective drawing, we first want to establish the horizon line, so I draw a horizontal line across the paper and mark it HL for identification purposes. Next, I locate the center of vision on the horizon line as well as a line of sight. And if you recall, the line of sight is the direction in which the viewer is looking, and the center of vision is the center of the scene that will be drawn. On the line of sight, I'm locating a point, and I'm going to call this point the station point, or SP. And I'm just locating it about a half an inch up from the bottom of the paper. This station point can be located in just about any place, but I'm using this as a way to show you how the left and right vanishing points in two-point perspective are connected to each other. So using my triangle, I put the corner of the 90-degree angle on that station point and rotate it to find two points along the horizon line for my vanishing points. And I label those on the left side the LVP and on the right side the RVP. Notice also that I do not draw lines all the way to the horizon line on those. I just mark the points. As you rotate your triangle, they move, right, opposite each other. Now, you can also randomly just locate two vanishing points, but you've got to be careful not to have them too close together, because the objects that you draw have to be located between those two vanishing points, and if there's a little bit of space, it gets difficult to draw stuff. There's also a way to draw vanishing points off the page, but that's for another video. Next, I locate the front corner of the plane, the flat plane that I am going to draw. And this is just a random choice. And I connect that point to both the left and right vanishing points. And now I'm going to locate another point along that line that is drawn on the right there. And I connect that point to the left vanishing point. Now remember, the rule of perspective says that all parallel lines converge to the same vanishing point on the horizon, so I need to connect that point to that left vanishing point because it runs parallel to that far left side. Since this is going to be gridded or a divided plane, think checkerboard, I need to figure out a number of divisions, the number of divisions that I want. And so at the front corner, I draw a horizontal line and mark off along that line a set of units. And in this case, I wanted 5 units, and I just marked out every inch to get that number that I needed. Then I take that rightmost measurement and I draw a line through the right back corner to the horizon line, and I get a measuring point. And I want to make sure that I mark that MP. That'll distinguish it from vanishing points or center of vision. And where these lines intersect the right edge, I now have new points that are needed to connect to the vanishing point. So you can see as they go from my measuring point, cross through that line that runs to the right vanishing point, I get new intersections. And then at each intersection, I draw a line that goes to the left vanishing point. I hope that makes sense. This is why I talk about it and draw it at the same time. It helps. Now just notice how each of those spaces is getting smaller as it moves towards that horizon line, showing us that there is some foreshortening going on. Now I'm going to choose the depth of a new row on the left side, and I just eyeball what looks close to being a squared space in perspective, and I draw a line to the right vanishing point this time. My first row of squares is now done. Now I just need to finish off more boxes. And so I just bisect the first square from corner to corner all the way to the horizon. And I also label this a measuring point to avoid getting confused later. And as that new line intersects the already drawn lines, I have points with which to connect to the right vanishing point. So don't forget this step. Sometimes people stop. And all I need to do is connect each of those. and I have a gridded space. So now I just switch to my graphite pencil, and I just need to go over my construction lines with that graphite to reveal my gridded floor plane. One thing that you should always remember when you're working in perspective is to keep your pencils nice and sharp. If you have trouble doing this, as I've mentioned in other videos, a good way to work precisely, especially in perspective, is to utilize mechanical pencils. And in this drawing, I have a mechanical pencil, that's my red pencil, and a mechanical pencil, that's my graphite pencil. And it just keeps my drawings nice and neat. The other thing is I want to be sure and draw lightly as I work. That helps me if I need to erase anything. It's much easier to do and doesn't create such a big mess. Well, there you have it, a gridded floor plane in two-point perspective. Now, why don't you try your hand at doing it? Thanks for watching.